X-ray special segment of Today in LA Weekend. Well, one of the big questions on Election Day, the race for district attorney. Jackie Lacey is the 42nd DA for the County of Los Angeles. She's seeking a third term against former San Francisco DA George Gascon, who we will hear from in a moment. So, Madam Prosecutor, the criticism is that you are an old school DA and that times have changed. The public is demanding criminal justice reform, alternatives to incarceration, and that you are not a leader in that movement. What is your response?
You know, if you're going to do criminal justice reform, it has to be real reform and not window dressing. And because I have been involved in the system, I'm an expert now. And I'm an expert in the subject matter as well as I have the relationships. So here's an example. In LA County, I've led mental health reform. I've launched the conviction review unit, and I've done other things. My opponent from San Francisco tried to do those things there. And his mental health proposal came a year after mine. It fell flat on its face. It was voted down because he doesn't have the infrastructure of relationships. He sought our advice on how to open up a conviction review unit, and he never opened it up. And so what I'm saying is there's rhetoric. There's general rhetoric out there about reform. But really, when you're talking about real reform, you need a practicing lawyer. You need someone who has the relationships in LA County, who knows LA County. An outsider with an ego, who is a politician, is not going to be effective in change. And so what I'm saying is, I hear you. I realize we need change. I'm an African-American woman who has experienced racism. We have filed cases. That's actually a myth. That we haven't filed cases, but we file the cases based on evidence, not necessarily based on what can win.
There have been protests outside your office for years now by Black Lives Matter. There were protests outside your house, famously with your husband brandishing a firearm at them. I know you and he have both apologized for that. He's been charged with a misdemeanor. And Congressman Adam Schiff, Mayor Eric Garcetti have pulled their endorsement of you and now back your opponent. What's your response to all of this? And do you think the tide is shifting since the George Floyd demonstrations earlier this year?
I really think it is. I always felt it was trending in my direction when others didn't. Initially, after the George Floyd homicide, I saw politicians get scared for their own skin. They were basically nervous. They didn't, you know, that's why you saw the knee-jerk reaction of defund the police. That really started in Minneapolis right after that happened. That's why you're seeing people who are in politics and who are politicians sort of try to get in front of the protesters, get with BLM. BLM has changed. Black Lives Matter LA has changed so much just in the last months after George Floyd. It really was a grassroots organization. And then the next thing you know, the politicians got involved, and I see the message sort of getting lost a bit, if you will. I've always felt that people want good police departments. They want better police departments. They don't want less police, because when you're talking about less police, that means when you need to, when you're in trouble and you need to call somebody, you want them there in a matter of minutes. But people are nervous. They're scared. We've been through a lot of trauma. I've had people who never would have owned the gun, never would have owned a gun in their life, call and say, now, how do I get a registered firearm? So I believe that in the end, there's a silent majority who says, yes, we want police officers held accountable who violate the law. But we don't want to dismantle police departments. We want better police departments. We want better mental health care. And I have been a champion for that. But they also don't want people breaking into their homes. They don't want people stealing their cars. They don't want people assaulting them, okay? And they want to know that there's somebody strong in that DA's office who's going to back it up when the chips are down and you need justice.
What has this campaign been like personally for you?
I am so rooted in my Christian faith, and I have prayed more during this period of unrest than I ever have in my entire life. I'm grateful for all of the adversity that has come my way, because it has reminded me that you know, that I'm stronger than I ever thought I was. I was a pretty shy, quiet kid. The rub on me as a DA was, she's not political enough. She's not out there enough. She's too quiet. And this has forced the lion in me to come out and stand and look adversity in the face and say, you will not intimidate me. You will not run me out of my job.
LA County District Attorney Jackie Lacey, candidate for re-election. Thanks for taking the time.
Thank you, Conan. Thanks a lot for having me on.